Hello everyone, I'm Ruchika Gupta from SuccessCDs Education. I'm back with a weekly dose of current affairs. Today we'll discuss current affairs for 20th to 26th May 2018. This video is in English. अगर आप हिंदी का वीडियो देखना चाहते हैं, उसका लिंक नीचे डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दिया गया है. So let us begin with the current affairs. Question number 1. Which organization organized the Shiksha Mela Education Open Day? Shiksha Mela Education Open Day was organized by which organization? These are the four options and the correct answer to this is option B, UNICEF. UNICEF, which is an arm of United Nations organization. UNICEF stands for United Nations Children's Emergency Fund. So UNICEF India along with the Ministry of Human Resource Development organized the Shiksha Mela Education Open Day. Now we see question number 2. Name the rare critically endangered bird for whose conservation the SBVCR won the India Biodiversity Award 2018. So the India Biodiversity Award 2018 has been given to an NGO, SBVCR. Which is involved in the conservation of a rare critically endangered bird species and we have to name that bird. The correct answer to this is option C, Bhuvan Leosichla. Let us see some more information. Arunachal Pradesh based NGO Singchung Bhuvan Community Reserve SBVCR has won the India Biodiversity Award 2018 in the conservation of wildlife species category. It was awarded for its efforts to conserve the rare critically endangered bird Bhuvan Leosichla. This is the bird. So now we know SBVCR, that is Singchung Bhuvan Community Reserve, is based in Arunachal Pradesh. The India Biodiversity Award is given in four categories. And the four categories are number 1, conservation of threatened species. Number 2, sustainable use of biological resources. Number 3, successful models for access and benefit sharing. And number 4, biodiversity management committees. Let us see some more information about this reserve, SBVCR, Singchung Bhuvan Community Reserve. It is a 17 square kilometer biodiversity hotspot in Arunachal Pradesh. It was instituted under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. It is home to critically endangered bird species Bhuvan Leosichla, which is not reported anywhere else in the world. So this is the only place where this bird is found. This NGO lies right next to Eagle's Nest Wildlife Sanctuary, which is also a biodiversity hotspot. Question number 3. Where is the Patratu Super Thermal Power Project located? We have to tell the location of Patratu Super Thermal Power Project. The correct answer is option B, Jharkhand. Prime Minister of India Narendra Modi has laid the foundation stone of NTPC's coal-based Patratu Super Thermal Power Project in Jharkhand. This project is a joint venture between the government of Jharkhand and Patratu Vidyut Utpadan Nigam Limited, which is a part of NTPC. Question number 4. Sushant Singh Rajput has tied up with Dash to promote women entrepreneur. Sushant Singh Rajput is a famous media personality. He has tied up with an organization to promote women entrepreneurs. We have to tell the name of that organization and the answer to this is option B, Niti Aayog. Question number 5. When is the World Thyroid Day observed? The answer is May 25. And the first World Thyroid Day was observed in the year 2009. Question number 6. United States of America has withdrawn invitation for 2018 RIM of the Pacific Maritime Exercise known as RIMPAC for which country? United States of America has taken back its invitation for the RIMPAC exercise to one country. Which is that country? The answer is China. RIMPAC is the world's largest international maritime warfare exercise. It is held biannually near Honolulu, Hawaii during June and July of even-numbered years. It is held once every 2 years during those years which are even. Now we see question number 7. Which of these schemes has not been included in the Samagra Shiksha Scheme? Samagra Shiksha Scheme has compiled many schemes related to education. But one of these schemes is not a part of this scheme. We have to tell which one that is. The answer is Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. So this scheme, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, is not a part of Samagra Shiksha Scheme. So the other three schemes, Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, Teacher Education, they are all a part of Samagra Shiksha Scheme. Some more information about this. Samagra Shiksha is the first integrated scheme extending unified support to states from preschool to senior secondary level. Now we see question number 8. Surya Kiran 2018 is the dash edition of the exercise. So we have to tell that the Surya Kiran of the year 2018 is which edition of Surya Kiran? The answer to this is 13th. So Surya Kiran 2018 is the 13th edition of Surya Kiran. The 13th edition of India-Nepal Joint Military Exercise will be conducted at Pitorgarh in Uttarakhand from 30 May to 12 June 2018. Surya Kiran is a series of bilateral military exercises. They are conducted biannually, alternatively in India and Nepal. Question number 9. What is the venue of the 5th India CLMV Business Conclave? The answer is Cambodia. Now CLMV stands for Cambodia, Lao PDR, Myanmar and Vietnam. Question number 10. The all-women crew of INS Tarini has been honoured with which award? The all-women Navy crew of INS Tarini has recently completed its journey around the globe and it has been honoured with an award. We have to name the award. The answer is Nari Shakti Puraskar, which was given away on the Women's Day. The 6 women crew of INS Tarini undertook task of circumnavigating the globe as part of Indian Navy's Navika Sagar Parikrama expedition. Now we see question number 11. Where will India's first national sports university be set up? What is the venue of India's first national sports university? The answer is Manipur. Question number 12. Which country hosted its first ever Shanghai Cooperation Organization Regional Anti-Terrorist Structure known as SCO RATS Legal Experts Meeting? We have to tell the host country, that country which hosted the first ever SCO RATS Legal Experts Meeting. The answer is Pakistan. Pakistan became a permanent member of SCO along with India in June. SCO stands for Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Now, Regional Anti-Terrorist Structure known as RATS is a permanent organ of SCO. It is headquartered in Tashkent in Uzbekistan. And the head of RATS is elected to 3-year term. Each member state sends permanent representatives to RATS. RATS is an arm of SCO and its full form is Regional Anti-Terrorist Structure. Question number 13. Name the first Southeast Asian country to eliminate trachoma. Which is the first Southeast Asian country that has eliminated the disease of trachoma? The answer is Nepal. The World Health Organization has validated Nepal for having eliminated trachoma, a contagious bacterial infection of the eye. And this makes Nepal the first country in World Health Organization's Southeast Asia region to defeat trachoma program. So, the World Health Organization had organized a program to eliminate trachoma and Nepal is the first country that has achieved this. India had self-declared itself free from infective trachoma in December 2017 after it met the goal of trachoma elimination as specified by WHO under its Get 2020 program. So the World Health Organization had launched a program known as Get 2020, Global Elimination of Trachoma by the year 2020. Now we see question number 14. Name the new chairman of Press Council of India. The answer is C.K. Prasad. Question number 15. The deadly Nipah virus gets its name from Sungai Nipah, a village. Where is Sungai Nipah village located? Now, we have all heard about this deadly virus called Nipah virus. This name comes from the name of a village, Sungai Nipah. And we have to tell, where is this village Sungai Nipah located? The answer is Malaysia. Now, the Nipah virus infection is a zoonotic disease, that is, it is transmitted to humans from animals, that causes severe disease in both animals and humans. Right now, the source is not yet identified, but it is said that fruit bats or flying foxes are the natural host of Nipah virus. Now we see question number 16. Name NASA's twin satellites that will track Earth's water cycle. The answer is GRACE FO. GRACE FO stands for Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment Follow-on. It was launched on board of SpaceX pre-flown Falcon 9 rocket from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California, USA. Question number 17. Name the UAV, unmanned aerial vehicle manufactured by DRDO, Defense and Research Development Organization, which is undergoing trials. Recently, the DRDO has developed a unmanned aerial vehicle which is undergoing trials. What is the name of this unmanned aerial vehicle, or we call it drone also? The answer to this is Rustam 2. This is Rustam 2. It is a part of the Rustam line of unmanned aerial vehicles developed indigenously by the DRDO. And this range includes Rustam 1, Rustam H and Rustam C. Now we see question number 18. Name the winner of the Man Booker International Prize 2018. Who has been given the Man Booker International Prize 2018? The answer is Olga Tokarczuk. Olga Tokarczuk is a Polish author, and the translator Jennifer Croft. Both of them have been given this award, Man Booker International Prize 2018. Now, this prize is given to those novelists who have written in a language other than English and their work has been translated into English. So this award is shared between the author and the translator. Olga won the prize with English translation of her novel Flights, which charts multiple journeys in time, space and human anatomy. Now we see question number 19. What is India's rank in the HAQ index? HAQ stands for Healthcare Access and Quality. The answer is 145. India ranked 145th among 195 countries in terms of healthcare access and quality index in the year 2016, behind its neighbors like China, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Bhutan. So India is behind all these countries. The top 5 countries with the highest level of healthcare access and quality in 2016 are Iceland, Norway, Netherlands, Luxembourg and Finland and Australia. So the 5th position is shared by Finland and Australia. Now we see question number 20. Name the new software for disease monitoring launched by the Rajasthan government. The Rajasthan government has launched a software for disease monitoring. We have to name that software. The answer is Nidan. Question number 21. When is the International Biodiversity Day celebrated? The answer to this is 22nd May. So every year, 22nd May is celebrated as International Biodiversity Day, and the theme for this year is celebrating 25 years of action for biodiversity. It marks the 25th anniversary of entry into force of the Convention on Biological Diversity. On the occasion, National Mission for Clean Ganga and World Wildlife Federation India jointly organized a workshop called Ganga and its Biodiversity, developing a roadmap for habitat and species conservation in New Delhi. So this workshop was organized in New Delhi. Now we see question number 22. Which country has developed the world's first floating nuclear power station? The world's first floating nuclear power station has been developed by which country? The answer is Russia. This is the world's first floating nuclear power station. Russia has unveiled the world's first floating nuclear power station at the port city of Murmansk. It will be loaded with nuclear fuel and will be towed to the port of Pevek in the autonomous Chukotka region in Russia's far northeast in Arctic Circle region. Academic Lomonosov is named after the Russian academician Mikhail Lomonosov. So the name of this nuclear power plant is Academic Lomonosov. Now we see question number 23. According to Afrasia Bank Global Wealth Migration Review, what is India's rank in the list of wealthiest nations of the world? So in the list of the wealthiest nations of the world, what is India's rank? The answer is 6th. The top 10 countries in this ranking are United States of America at number 1, China at number 2, Japan at number 3, United Kingdom at number 4, Germany at number 5, India at number 6, Australia at 7th position, 8th position is held by Canada, 9th position by France and Italy at 10th position. Now we see question number 24. Name the relay satellite launched by China to explore the moon. The answer to this is QQ. QQ meaning Bridge of Magpies satellite will serve as a communications relay for future Chang'e 4 rover that will explore in South Pole Atkinson Basin in Moon's far side. So the Moon's dark side, South Pole Atkinson Basin, there this Chang'e 4 rover will explore the Moon's surface and QQ will help this rover. Question number 25. Where was the 26th Basic Ministerial Meeting of Environment Ministers held? The answer is South Africa. Basic is a group of four countries, Brazil, South Africa, India and China. This meeting was attended by Basic countries and Michael Kurtkia of Poland, next president of Conference of Parties, COP24, under the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. India was represented by Union Environment Minister Harshvardhan. With this we come to an end. Thank you for watching this video and for more videos do subscribe to SuccessCDs Education.